I'm going to show you how to download and use free mockups with Adobe Photoshop. So if this video interests you so well, stick around, I will show you how.
It's Double T Friday!
Tips and Tricks Friday.
Hello you guys, welcome and welcome back to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn graphic design and how to make creative designs, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you get notified when I upload another video like this one. I guess you still remember those days in school that a teacher will give mock tests or mock exams in school, and these exams are not actually real exams or real tests. It's to show you how the real test will look like. That is where the name mockup comes from. Mockups are not the real designs. It's actually a presentation of how the real design will look like. So placing your designs on a mockup simply means you want to see how the real design or how your design will come out in real life. Actually, the best way to present your designs to your clients are through mockups, because not everyone understands 2D designs. So most people need to see the 3D look of your design before they understand how your design looks like. So what you should know is that mockups are the best options to see how your design will look like when it is brought into life. The best website I will recommend for downloading mockups, though there are lots of websites, but the best I will recommend is FreePic. And next one I will recommend is Mockup World, but for this tutorial I'm going to use FreePic. So let's head on to the computer and see how we can download a mockup. The first thing you want to do is to launch your browser. For me, I'm using Google Chrome, so I'm going to launch my browser. And next thing you want to do is to search for freepic.com. So I'm going to type here. And search for that, and it opens up this website. And next thing you need to do is search here for mockups, and you will see different varieties of mockups. All you have to do is to choose the mockup that fits the purpose of your design, or maybe you are making a logo design or any other design you choose. And note this: most of these mockups are free and they are also premium version. So to get premium mockups, you have to sign up for the premium version of FreePic. So for now, I'm using the free version, so I'm going to go straight to free mockups. Actually, I want to download free mockups, so I'm going to search for the mockup that fits my design. Okay, I feel this will be perfect. So I'm going to click on this and click on download, and you see free download. You click here and it starts downloading automatically. So this is the process you have to use to download all your mockups. Now this process applies to every other mockup you will need from freepic.com. You just have to use this process to download either your logo mockups, your flyer mockups, or any other mockup. So let's see what our mockup looks like. So now what you will need to do is to check out your folder where the mockup download was saved. So I'll go to my download where I saved the mockup, and this is it. It comes as a zip file. Now the only application that can open up this zip file is 7-zip. So if you don't have 7-zip on your computer, you have to download it, or if you have it already, then you are good to go. So I'm going to open up this zip file like this, and it comes out this way. And most times you need to extract the content, but if you don't need to extract, let me show you how to extract the content. I have to close this and right click on the zip file and click on extract to notebook mockup with black elements, black background. Click on this and it extracts all the files inside the zip file, so you can open it up easily. You just have to give it some time till it finish extracting. Okay, this is the extracted folder, so I'm going to double click on the extracted folder, and these are all the files inside the mockup. So I'm going to double click on the Photoshop file. So this is the mockup itself, and next thing you need to do is to place your design on this mockup. And the only way to place your design is to look for the placeholder. Now every mockup has a placeholder where you place your design. Most times the designers of this mockup state on the layer placeholder, and most times they do not state it, but you just have to use your own IQ to know where the placeholder layer is. So I think this is the placeholder layer, so I'm going to double click on this thumbnail and it opens up this way, and the next thing I need to do is to bring in my design and place. But before then, I have to delete off all these original layers that comes with the mockup. So I'm going to delete this layer here, delete group and content, delete group and content here. So the next thing I'm going to do is to bring in my design to the placeholder. I'm going to click here and open up where my design is located, pick here, drag to Photoshop. Now all I want is the front cover of my design only, so I'm going to enlarge my design and press shift on your keyboard while doing this, so your design won't be scaled wrongly. You just have to make sure your design is placed perfectly. This is just the front. Okay, this is perfect. Click here and it saves. All you have to do again is to press Ctrl S on your keyboard and save the placeholder. Then you close it and automatically it comes out on your design. So this is how it looks like. This is how the mockup looks like. And next thing you want to do is to save this mockup file as a JPEG, so it comes out like a picture format. So I'm going to press Ctrl Shift S and it brings out the save as dialog box. Then you choose the location where you want to save your file. I'll save it on my desktop and I'm going to change the save as type to JPEG. Okay, and save. And this dialog box pops up, you click on okay and the file is saved. So I'm going to open up my file like this. So this is how the mockup looks like, and this applies to any other mockup file you download from freepik.com or any other website. It follows the same process. All you have to do is to open up the thumbnail where you have to place your design, and after placing your design, you save and close that particular thumbnail which you open, and it comes out on the main mockup file itself. That process continues to every mockup you download. And I'm going to show you another example. Let's see this. And this is my zip file once again. I'm going to right click here and extract to frame folder. Okay, this is the extracted folder. So I'm going to double click and open the folder, and this is the Photoshop file. Double click to open up the Photoshop file. So it opens up in your Photoshop, and like I said before, every mockup comes with a placeholder. So I'm going to search for my placeholder and it's not visible here, so I'm going to click on this group layer where it says edit design here. You click and you see edit design here. I strongly believe this is my placeholder, so I'm going to click on the thumbnail, double click on the thumbnail, and it opens up like this. So this is actually the folder. Create a new layer and delete this other layer, so you take off the original design that comes with the mockup. So I'm going to open up my folder again and pick up my file which I want to place on the mockup, take it to my Photoshop and place here. Then press shift on your keyboard and enlarge the design like this. This looks perfect. Okay, click on okay and Ctrl S to save. And once you are done saving, close up the thumbnail like this and it opens up in your mockup file or your real mockup file. Yeah, it looks very perfect. So I'm going to save my mockup. Press Ctrl Shift S to save it as a JPEG. Choose the location where you want to save it. Change the file type to JPEG and save. So once you are done saving, you can now open up your file on the location where it was saved. So I'm going to open up my file once again. And this is the final look of my mockup. So this process applies to every mockup you need to download, ranging from logo mockups to notebook mockups to flyer mockups and any other mockup you need to download. If you found this video helpful, give this video a thumbs up and make sure you like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any other alternative of getting mockups, let me know down in the comments and I'll appreciate that so much. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you next time.